Hello and welcome to the second part of this tutorial. Last week we colored the skin and this week we are gonna do the eyes, lips and the crown. First of all, I'm gonna use Chatterous 989 and as you can see I'm using lines towards the center of the iris and leaving a lot of white space. The second pencil that we'll be using is Grass Green 909 and we'll be concentrating on the outer edges of the iris and just coming in a bit along those lines. Then we'll be using the 989 Chatterous pencil again to fill up and blend the eye so that it looks all smooth. Please be careful to leave that white space remaining so that it has that reflective quality of the eye, because without that it will look quite dead and bland. For the white part of the eye, because never is an eye's white part completely white, so we are going to use 20% gray there for both sides and the top, and then the 50% gray, the cool gray, for the darkest areas as well. Then for that part, the pinkish part, we are gonna use blush pink underneath and over on both eyes. You can use a white gel pen to create those highlights on the eye, but at this moment when I check my white ink pen, it had all dried up, so that's why I'm leaving that space. And for the second eye, I thought I'll use a second color, a blue, and we are going to use the light aqua blue, and again we are going to come in with lines towards the center, and as the second color we're going to use 932 violet. The first one was light aqua 992 and the second one was 932 violet. So as you can see, I use this same light green and light blue for the skin as well last week, and we are gonna use these same pencils throughout so that the whole page has a unified color theme or scheme. Additionally, we'll be using the black color for the iris as well to even darken it further, and then use the black, draw those eyelashes and give a nice dark feel right under the top eyelid so that it creates those shadows. Same for the other eye. I'm just drawing that line as well because it's kind of faded. On that place it got a bit too much, so I'm trying to blend in that using the 20% cool gray. And yeah, you can always use that pencil. For each of these, the details we are gonna be going through on the face, you need the pencils to be extra sharp because these are small areas and you don't want a fat tip. Now as you saw, I took the black pencil and colored the middle part of the eye black as well while leaving those white parts blank. So if we drew over those white parts, it won't have that nice quality where you can see it resembles a much more real eye. Now when we color the lips, I'm first gonna draw lines like this using Lilac 956 and Towards the edges, you saw that I curved the lines, and we are going to have the light in on coming in from the top right. So the right side of the bottom lip is going to have the most shine, whereas the top lip would have less of a shine, except for that top right part that I am leaving alone without coloring. I am leaving it blank as in white color, and the rest of the lip will be shaded. Now I am going to use Parma Violet 1008. I am going in, and the darkest part of the lip is the place where both lips come together, plus the areas at the bottom. And I'm going to use this pencil to go along those lines again and darken the lip further, the bottom and top, while leaving that space empty in white. Now I'm using the lilac again to blend in everything. These Prismacolor pencils blend well, so you need to use that to your advantage and nicely blend in the pencils, two or three colors together, to get a nice smooth look. And lastly, for the lips, we'll be using Violet 932. Again, at the center where both lips meet. And then I'm gonna go a small amount of distance upwards, and from the middle of the lip downwards. And I'm using the lilac to blend in those colors again. Now for the eyebrows, and I'm using first of all the Chatterrose 989 and the light aqua on the other side of the other eyebrow, just to do the same thing as we did for the skin, where that the greens and blues get reflected off the skin. And now with a really fine pointed black pencil, I'm gonna draw in the eyebrows. It needs to be really fine, and we need to leave some white space or that green and blue space, so that you can see that these are actually strands of hair for the eyebrow, without just coloring the whole thing in black color and making it flat. Now I'm going to use the same three colors I used for the lips for that gem in the middle of the forehead. First of all, I'm going to use lilac, and I'm careful to leave a space at the top right with a small margin of lilac white. Then I'm going to use Parma Violet 1008. And what I'm doing here is, it will be dark at the top right and fade to lilac at the bottom left. So I made it dark again with Parma Violet, and then I'm gonna use the violet to make it really dark and leave that white space there. Now I'm taking the lilac again to smother the color, to blend it in nicely, so that you get that circular or roundish look for the gem. For those small balls, like pearls like thing, okay, before that, for the steel like part, what we are gonna do is use gray, 20% gray, 20% cool gray, and 50% cool gray, keeping in mind the I'll be you should get the shadows on the bottom left and the top right, but the top right it will be towards the gem, and at the bottom left it will be away from the gem. Smooth it out with the 20% gray. Now I'm going to use the 50% gray to draw circles on those beads. When I'm drawing the circle, you can see that I'm leaving out white at the bottom left and around the center of those. These are actually quite small details on the picture, and you can't really work a lot on them because there are limitations on actually what you can do considering the available space that is there to color. Now we are going to color the crown, and we are going to do a silver crown, and what I am going to use is again the same three colors, which is 20% cool gray, 50% cool gray and black. Other than that, I'll be using the light green, which is Chatterose 989, and the aqua, light aqua, which is 992, for those color reflections. First of all, I'm going to use the 50% gray, and since these are the silver shines in a different way, so is what we are going is for highly polished silver. And so you can see I'm gonna color areas on a sideway motion on selected areas, and the highest light percentage of light still comes from the top right, so we are gonna have the darkest shadows on this side, on the left side of the crown. But since it's a metal, we are still gonna have those shadows, or I don't know what to call them, but those are reflections off of the polished metal. So, or the actual metal color, and the white area is gonna be the reflection. So we are gonna have less of that gray area on the right side. Now we're going to use the 20% cool gray to blend in that 50% cool gray, and as you can see, I use the 50% the dark pencil on the sides also. Those are just random places that I chose to apply that dark gray. So we keep on blending using the 20% gray. As you can see now itself, you get that kind of a roundish look. And the fact that this crown will be having a lot of white space means that it will only be apparent, the look of it will really shine through once the hair is added. It needs a background color to really pop. So that will happen when we get to that stage of the drawing. Now what I'm doing is again using that 50% gray to add some more dark areas. And now I'm going to sharpen the black pencil and add that black into the places I think will be the darkest, including these shadows. So right at the middle of that dark area, I'm gonna get that black, and then using the 20% gray, I'm gonna really blend it in sideways so that it has that polished look. want to really get that polished look, you need to have all those lines go sideways and possibly where you can see those each strand of color. Black, a bit of black here and there. And along the darkest areas of the crown, right in the middle of those darkest grays, and then blend in with the 20% gray pencil. Just filling up the places where I think needs to have a bit of gray. Come back with the black and add in some black there. You see, when you add that, it just gives that roundish circular shape that we want to see. We want this to be circular, wrapping around the head, not flat. So this shading technique will help us give that nice circular look to the crown. And now what we are going to do is use this same purple, blue and green for the crown's gems. Like I said before, we want a common color theme throughout the page. It's not always needed. You can even use all the colors in the box that you have, the colored pencils, but sometimes it's better to have a limited palette of colors or just a set number of colors. So in this case, what we're using is the grays, greens, pinks, blues, just maybe altogether about 4 or 5 main colors and variations of it. So here, that was a mistake there, but what I'm planning is having the green ones. Again, kind of a mistake there, so I need to erase that. But we are gonna have that bottom row with green and blue. Again, we are starting with the lightest pencils. The green is the Chatterous, which is PC989, and the blue is Light Aqua 992. So when I'm coloring these gems, what I'm actually doing is the almost same thing as I did for that purplish gem in the middle of the face, where I leave a spot of white and color the rest. But in this case, I've left another line of white at the bottom left. So the same with the crowns, that the purple and the green as well. Even at this time, you can see that those have a certain 3D-ish quality to them, right? Now we are going to take the grass green pencil for the green ones and tighten up the color in there. So it's 909 grass green, and so that the darkest hue of green would be where that white color space is also adjoining that, and towards the bottom right it will fade. Same with the blue. Now for the blue, I am using Indigo Blue 901 to color that up. And for those smaller gems, really there's not enough space to work in there. So my main goal was to just keep some white space and color the rest. Now I'm taking that light aqua again, PC992, to blend in and to saturate that color even more, and then go back with the blue indigo 901 and tighten up the color again, just so that it gets a bit more darker. Now for the purple color gems, I'm using the second color, which is Parma Violet 1008. Again, I'm being mindful of keeping that white spot vacant, especially since I don't have that the white Uniball pen, I don't remember the name, but that gel-like pen. So keep that space vacant, and then we are going to use the Violet 932 pencil. As you can see, the darkest part is also where that white spot is, and towards the bottom left we'll shade it and gradually reduce the color up to lilac. This will give your gems a nice kind of realistic look. And to get that color even maybe a bit deeper, again I'm gonna use that violet just to maybe a bit darker, a bit harder with the pencil to get that deep, and then use some black, slightly apply some black, very lightly like that, and then use lilac to blend that in so that it gives that deepness to the gem. Now, just as with the skin, I'm going to use that light aqua pencil 992 to add some reflections on the crown. So the flowers are supposed to be blue, and I'm going to use that blue color to add some reflections to the crown. Same with the chatterous, the green, which is 989. So we can obviously leave the crown with gray only, but when you add these colors from the background, you will notice that this, the whole thing becomes one, the skin, the crown. And once we add the colors for the grass, the grass as in those leaves and the flowers, you will see that all of the elements look like they belong there, because they are lending and getting color from each of those elements that are there. Even if you take a photograph in a, for example, say a blue room, you will get that blue on your skin, right? Otherwise, I mean, if you don't add that blue, it will, you will look as if you've been placed in there. So the same with the crown or the skin, you need to borrow some color from the surrounding objects and add that to your other elements like the crown or skin. So now I'm using that blender pencil, the Prismacolor colorless blender, to blend in all of those colors, the green and the blue, onto the crown. And I'm always going in this sideway motion. So that's it for today, and hope to see you in the next one.